Sturgill Simpson isn't primarily a one-genre artist. He did start out in the country scene, doing some outlaw country type stuff, but on his last album he totally broke out of that realm of country and went for something quite different. I see him as a rather versatile artist. On the last album that he put out, he did combine some gospel elements, some blues elements, some rock and psychedelic elements, all to create possibly his best album to date, actually. It was really cool to see a country artist just take that leap and it work really quite well. He continues that streak here with the album Sound and Fury. To accompany this album, there is a short film as well. I haven't seen the short film just yet. I did want to give it a watch, but I think I wanted to just talk about this standalone album because, you know, it is a separate album as well. It works on its own, so I'm going to just be talking about the album in question here. I mean, it wouldn't be released onto streaming services and there wouldn't be, like, you know, CD versions of this if it couldn't work on its own. So I think it's fair to say that, you know, you can listen to this separately and make your own judgment on the music itself. And as an album, it was quite a surprise to see Sturgill take another leap and incorporate disco and like almost dance punk elements on a couple of these tracks here. I for one was in friggin' shock when the third track burst through, the track Sing Along I mean, with that friggin' dance groove that I just did not see coming at all. And Sturgill seems to work really well on that track. He doesn't sound out of place at all. You would think he's really been doing this for quite a while. Sure, his voice isn't the most gripping. He doesn't come through with some really like exciting melodies because he is just singing in a pretty standard fashion, I think, but I think it does also work for the song. I would just say the song really needed to switch things up. I mean, it does kind of just keep the same instrumental from start to finish. It really could have done with, you know, a switch up at some point. Maybe the track could have, like, you know, started gaining even more momentum or something like that. Just something to spice it up. I think the second track has a solid groove to it as well. I really like the bass on this one. It's not quite as fast paced as Sing Along, but I think he also showcases that he can do this type of thing quite well, even when he pulls it back and doesn't quite go as bombastic with it. But when I say bombastic, I am really saying bombastic for Sturgill. Like, this is bombastic for him. This isn't bombastic for the genre. It is kind of just a simplistic approach to the sound, if I'm being honest. It is essentially just blending together some like disco elements and rock elements to kind of make this almost dance punk sound that we did hear a lot of in the 2000s. I could just name bands like The Rapture, and you would probably remember how good those songs were that they did, because they really made it their own and they had their own, you know, personality that came along with it. Whereas Sturgill is just kind of, I don't know, it's just kind of like a vanilla attempt, I think. I think I admire him for doing it more than I admire how it sounds. And then to top things off, he kind of just ditches it. Like, it's the album sets up this really cool idea that doesn't follow through with it, and I'm just left kind of confused. You get to track four, which is this really throwback boogie rock tune, which I think he does really well. Certainly better than some bands that attempt to do it today and are trying to throw it back to like the 70s or whatever. And I admire him for doing this, but once you get past track four, like, the songs really lose their touch to them. Like, they just kind of sound really generic. Track five, his vocals just completely blend in with everything. They kind of sound really muddy. They kind of sound really like squashed in the mix, and you can barely get anything out of what he's saying. The repetitious guitar riff on that track gets really stale too, and that was something I had an issue with the opening track, actually. Which just seemed to go on a little bit too long, didn't really go in a particularly interesting direction. I was kind of just waiting for it to end, to be honest. But that's the thing, it's not like I'm saying once you get past track four, like, all the songs are really boring or something. They're not. I think track six is actually a really fired up, like, banging blues rock tune. Last Man Standing 2, for as pretty standard as they are, like, sticking to the blues rock formula, they're still good for what they're going for. I just find it really weird that, you know, you get these really, like, completely out of the blue moments right at the beginning of the album for it then to just not really go anywhere. I just find it so strange. He laid the groundwork, he started building the blocks, and then like halfway through he just knocked the blocks down. It's like, dude, that's not how you play Jenga. Come on, man. The tracks themselves do sound decent for what they are, though, but they don't really impact me all that much, if I'm being honest. Like, they are just pretty standard blues rock tunes for the most part. And then you've got the 7-minute closing track that just doesn't really warrant the runtime. Kind of gets a bit stale. I'm just like, oh, come on, is this done yet? It ultimately all just sounds like an homage to sound and style that's been done over and over again plenty of years ago, and Sturgill unfortunately doesn't really bring it into his own, I don't think, here. Would have liked to have just seen what he could have done with more of the dancier tracks, to be honest. They were really fun and off the wall to me for his style. But unfortunately, this didn't really stick with me in the end. I think it might be weaker than his past two albums, I think. But it's admirable. I like that he's constantly changing his sound, his style, progressing it into different areas that he really hasn't touched on before. Reminds me of how King Gizzard keep doing a similar thing where they're dabbling in and out of these different genres and styles. They're getting so much praise for it, and yet to me, it just sounds like surface level interpretations of those sounds. So it's definitely respectable, but is it replayable? Not really. I'd just rather hear other bands that have done it way better in the past. So I'm gonna go 5.5 out of 10. Kind of let down with this one. I do like Sturgill a lot, but there's something here, and yeah, it just doesn't quite stick the landing for me. Let me know what you think of this album, though. I feel like this will do well for Sturgill. A lot of people will love this one, especially like rock fans. I think they're gonna really, really take to this. And absolutely love it. Let me know what you think. Thank you for watching my review. Hopefully you subscribe based on this review. If you haven't watched any other videos, check them out too. I can be positive sometimes. Thank you for watching. Have a good day. Subscribe and goodbye.